Look who's here!
Look who we found!
I know! Again. Mel and Greg. Well, for some of you who watched my series from South Africa, I got to spend 2 weeks with these guys in South Africa. And before that, we met in Germany. So this is our third time on third continent.
Yeah.
So we get to spend a couple of days here in a Newfoundland. I learned how to pronounce that properly, Newfoundland. So now we're heading to Christians and we're about to get screeched in. We are in. We got a space at the bar. We got our first drinks, and now we are waiting for the ceremony.
Maybe you're from New York City, but I know them for me. I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one fly high. Then they'll rip the day they try to take our Newfoundland. I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one till I die. I'm proud to be in no place I would rather be than here in Newfoundland.
Bring the royal order of screechers to order. I understand we got a bunch that want to get screeched in here today.
Woo!
Hopefully becoming right proper honorary Newfoundlanders. The idea of the ceremony is to try to teach you a little bit about Newfoundland. When all is said and done, you're going to be called honorary Newfoundlanders. I have paperwork done up for you all. Do not lose the paperwork once you receive it, as you can get into more places with this than most passports these days. As we're about to begin, I should first let you know that I'm not the son of a fisherman or a lighthouse keeper. I don't eat fish three times a day, and I don't drink screech. Ever. At least not before noon on weekdays. I'm not the guy that build a boat, I'm not the guy that sailor, but I got a boat with a fine four cuddy, and it's got high top sails, and I painted it green, and it's the prettiest boat.
Yeah,
people have heard of me. Awesome. Not Newfoundland or Newfoundland. Newfoundland is the oldest settlement in North America, the youngest province in Confederation, and the only rock you can party on. My name is Skipper Lukey, and I is a Newfoundlander. Thank you. Now, just so you know, that this is actually fit to eat. I prepared this for many a fine chef over the years. The most recent one was out of Montreal. His name was Chef Martin Picard, or Martin Picard. I don't know how you'd say it in French, but he's got two of the top restaurants in the country, and after he tasted it, he called me Chef Lukey. I use a screech. I burned off all the alcohol. I added some Cajun seasoning. I deglazed the pan with port, and I finished it with saffron. Who does that to bologna? Yes, so do not worry about it if you're a vegetarian. There's no meat in this. Purely organic. Okay. I'll be coming around, starting with Mike.
Thank you, Sue.
Samantha.
Yeah.
Kinga.
Thank you.
And
Scott.
Greg. Thank you. Melon? Was it Melon?
Yes, Melon. Thank you.
Good. Good. And your first name? Heather?
You're going to mess with him though.
Lori?
Good.
Cajun. Yes. This is a real Newfoundland codfish. Given the chance, this fish could have grown to the height of 6 feet tall and weighed as much as 130 pounds. This fish will not grow any more than this because it's dead.
Science.
And it fits perfectly in our freezer. The significance of this particular fish, why I love it so much, is that my daughter caught this fish last week out in Bonne Vista. And when she saw what was happening that day to all the other fish getting gutted and filleted and losing their cheeks and tongues to the restaurant, she wanted this fish, her fish, to become the most loved fish ever to come out of the waters of Newfoundland. And I promised her I was going to make that happen. I do need you all to pucker up and give this fish a little kiss. And not worry about anybody taking your picture or video doing so. Whatever happens here in St. John today will certainly be on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. While you're kissing this fish, make sure you hold the pose long enough to see a flash or hear a click. Otherwise, you will hear those horrible words. Do it again. You know, I can't actually force you all to kiss this fish involuntarily, you know. The health department has watched me very closely.
Are you going to selfie or something? She missed those cold lips.
The fish is gone, and I missed that. How's my hair?
That's how you do it, King. High five.
It started to freezing.
Facts. Screech got his name down on the south coast of our province, where one night we were serving up our hospitality to a U.S. captain. They drank the shot, and they yelled at a great big yell. Sergeant came on running into the room and said, "Who yelled out the god-awful screech?" And there was a Newfoundlander who was sitting at the bar that said, "Screech, boy, tis the rum, me son." And that's how Screech got his name. So, I never got you to sign any waiver forms, so for heaven's sake, don't get any of this on your skin. You can't have a drink without having a toast, so please wait till everybody gets their shot, and we'll do it together. Perfect. Nice. Kinga, would you mind passing a couple of words behind?
Absolutely. Here we go, guys. Thank you. Okay, big job.
Thank you. Here's to health in your company and one for the lasses. Let's drink and be merry all out of our glasses. Let's drink and be merry, but that's the refrain, for you may or may not ever all be here again.
Cheers.
Cheers. Okay. You should have got that.
You're not done.
You get another one.
You are past the screens, but you're not out of the woods.
Not bad.
Before I let you go, I'm going to say a small little phrase.
Do you like it?
Good. Excellent.
Say deed I is.
Me-o-cock.
Me-o-cock. Long may your big jib draw.
Long may your big jib draw.
By the power vested in me, I now declare you all honorary Newfoundlanders.
We passed! Like 20 minutes later, half an hour later, the sort of the ceremony is done, and I'm
honorary Newfoundlander.
And what do I reply?
Long may your big jib draw.
Long may your big jib draw.
May the wind be in your sails.
May the wind be in your sails.
That's basically what it means.
Ah, no, I wanted the whole sentence in Newfoundland.
Newfoundland. Say, understand?
I understand. Newfoundland, but no.
Newfoundland. It's not
Newfoundland.
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 There you go. Perfect. Deed I is.
Deed I is.
Me all cock.
Me all cock.
And long.
And long.
May your big.
May your big
jib draw.
There you go. Right. So, Brian.
Yes.
Is that, so this
Christians.
Right.
1879.
Right. So, it's literally continuously open, or you?
Always the same. Always Christians.
Always Christians.
Yeah, always the same. Yep,
right. Christians. And then how long you own the place?
Oh, I've been here for 30 years.
30 years? How old are you? Bloody hell.
I'm 68.
Oh, makes sense now. Right, so this is like the, do you guys have for the Screeched-In ceremony?
Yeah.
Is this the oldest tradition in this pub?
The Screech-In started many, many years ago with the Americans. The Americans had a military base in Argentia, and they used to call it the Brotherhood of Argentia Foreign Legion. They used to welcome Americans to the American base, and then when the base pulled out, the Newfoundland and Labrador Liquor Corporation rebranded it the Newfoundland Royal Order of Screechers, because it was a great promotion for their rum. So it's a welcoming ceremony now for everybody around the world.
Oh my God, you know what? Like, so I'm traveling around the world, but the moment I landed on the east sort of, you know, coast of Canada, I've heard about this and I just couldn't wait to come here to do this ceremony. So thank you very much.
You're welcome, Kinga.
Amazing experience, mate.
Excellent.
Morning. Morning, guys.
Hey.
Guess where we were for breakfast? Of course, Tom Hortons. Timmy's, that's right, Timmy's. That's right. So today we have a beautiful day and we're going for a little ride to
the easternmost point of North America.
Apparently. Because in South Africa we've been to most southern point. Which was in Cape Town.
Yep.
We did it together. So now we're gonna do it together here in Canada. Okay, let's do it. Yep.
Okay.
High five.
Cheers.
And today we have a lovely day. We're doing a little trip to the most eastern point of North America, I believe. It's not too far, it's only 15 kilometers from town. And then we're gonna head to the campground and just chill at the campground because that's not our last sort of night together. Because tomorrow I'll be heading to, yes, up the rock of the island to catch a ferry to Labrador. You know what I mean. Yes. So anyway, so this is our little adventure for today. This is pretty. Getting closer. Oh yeah, you can see the lighthouse already. Oh wow, that's a bit tight. And just like that, we made it to Cape Spear. And now we're walking to the most easternly point of North America.
North America. First sunlight of the continent.
It's a good one. I like it.
Yep.
First sunlight of the continent.
Ready?
Here it comes. Here it comes.
We made it.
Woo!
Oh, wait.
Yep.
Okay.
Ready.
Here we go.
Yes, yes, ready,
yes. Are you saying I'm already recording? Yes, I am.
Woohoo!
Made it!
Are we there yet?
Yep. Coming along.
Bloody walking. It's
way.
I reckon it's more than 500 meters away from my bike. To go back, it's way too windy. Right, now we're back in town. We just did some shopping. We'll be cooking tonight at the campground. Well, actually, we're hoping we're gonna get to the campground because we've never
We just haven't done any reservation, so we don't know if there is space. Because, yeah, a few days ago there was space, but I'm not sure how is the situation today. Anyway, we'll see. And welcome. Thank you. Registration. General store. Registration. Let's go here. Hey, we got a spot. Woo-hoo. Well, that was a bargain. $27 for three of us. Wow. I like traveling with these guys. Everything suddenly is cheaper because normally you just pay for the side. Right. Ready? Yeah, let's go. So we tenting. No. Exit loop. This way. Good. Duh. That's us. Great idea.
We all set up and we just realized that we actually, this is our first night camping. We spent like what, 2 weeks in South Africa together? Yeah. We never camped because it's way much cheaper to travel. Someone tends just moving around. So in South Africa it was very affordable for us to get like apartments, right? Like mm-hmm. three of us, it was very cheap. But now this was amazing deal. We're camping here for $27 for three people. Bargain. And this is our very special moment. We're camping together.
Yep. And we have a special treat for you.
What is it?
We are going to be re-screeched. Whoa! Tonight.
What could possibly go wrong? What could possibly go wrong?
Canadians? Oh, how much?
I'm testing my new chair. This is the life.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Mates.
Cheers.
So good. Cheers. So good. Cheers. So next time we're going to meet each other, you know, right in USA.
South
It'll
America.
Be another country, not another continent.
And I got more garlic.
No, garlic is at the end, isn't it?
Yes.
I know something about cooking, you know.
Do you? Then you can do this if you'd like.
What? All by myself?
All by myself. Now this will work.
Oh, look at you.
Look at that.
It's all mm-hmm. happening. It's all happening. So professional.
Yeah. This is one of those throw everything you have into the pot.
Yes. And I have the biggest job of all because I'm holding the camera.
There you go.
It's not on a camera. It didn't happen.
That's right. We didn't eat.
We didn't eat.
I feel like I'm in a prison. Hold on. I'll take my So classy.
There's your slop.
Oh, thank you. Oh, you're so much more gentle on your plate. Oh, unbelievable. These guys.
That's a lot.
I can't take him anywhere.
We have basmati rice with chicken, peppers, onion, and garlic, and mushrooms. And along with a salad.
Oops. Salad. You can, yeah.
Oh. Well, actually, you got 500. And you can stay with that if you want.
I will.
There you go. It was sort of. Where's my dildo? Oh.
Where's
here's my dildo.
Greg? I'm so pleased you found your dildo.
Oh, me too.
Did you throw one again?
Woo!